We're turning a 1987 Porsche 944 Turbo into a track day car that looks and goes like a rocket by beefing up the power in the engine and making the body lighter and more aerodynamic.
But this car has to look as good as it runs. So today I've come to the workshop early doors to fabricate some custom steel sills that'll add a Goblin touch to the exterior.
First things first, I need to cut these old sills off the car.
The sills are a really important structural element of the car that tie the front to the rear, but they are also prone to rot from damp weather.
You know what? That is not what I was expecting. That is clean. That means I'm not going to have to do any repair work for once. I'm making these new sills out of slightly thicker steel than the originals, just to make sure they are properly strong.
I want these sills to look like they belong to a lightweight rocket ship. So I'm cutting holes as part of the design.
I'm going to use a swaging tool to give that hole some form and rigidity.
These sills need to be watertight, otherwise they'll quickly rot out. So these holes, they need to be sealed.
I've cut these little metal discs and I'm actually going to weld them on the back of the holes to blank them off. Right, let's get this fitted to the car. I'm always a bit nervy doing this type of work because too much of a squeeze on this trigger and I've just blown a hole in this body. I'm really pleased with that. That's a simple little touch that has a big visual impact.
Making these custom sills not only looks great, but it only costs me 50 quid, and that leaves more money in the pot to spend on the engine's performance.
In less than 24 hours, I'll be benchmarking our track day Porsche against a standard 944 turbo to prove its performance and get a sale. The power upgrades and interior are now finished, taking our total spend to £17,000. But our final job is to give the exterior an eye-popping Goblin livery.
You know what? I love masking things up. I find it really therapeutic.
Why?
I don't know, but I think I actually spend too much time doing it. I get a bit obsessive. We've decided on a bold geometric pattern to really make this car stand out on the track.
I've wanted to do this to a car for absolutely ages. And I love the fact that we're taking inspiration from Razzle Dazzle Camouflage. It's so cool.
Dazzle Camouflage was painted on battleships in World War I. The geometric pattern confused the enemy so they couldn't tell what kind of boat it was or how fast it was travelling.
Right, I think we're ready to start painting.
This is way cooler than just sticking a load of stickers on it.
Exactly.
Proper way cooler. Because, yeah, we're rattle canning it in the workshop, but it's a proper finish.
All right, I think I'm done.
Right, let's start unwrapping this thing.
Voila!
We have just turned an old, skanky 944 into a track-going work of goddamn art.
Now the pressure's on me to prove this car runs as good as it looks.
Today, we're in sunny Wales at the Anglesey Race Circuit to test our Goblin Porsche 944. Oh, yeah.
Stand by for our best transformation yet. From an 80s yuppie to an ultra-lightweight contemporary track day car. The reconditioned turbo, ECU engine remap and boost control unit have upped the horsepower by a third from the standard 220 to 320. And racing brakes and suspension mean it should handle like a dream. Plus, the Le Mans inspired body kit, custom sills and razzle-dazzle design look epic. But if it doesn't perform, we won't find a buyer.
I'm going to sell this car on that photo alone.
And with £17,000 invested, we need to make a sale.
Yes, the car looks really good, but that's not actually enough. We need to get some stats so that we can prove it's a really good track day car.
How do we do that? Benchmark test.
First up, Hels is taking the wheel of a standard 944 turbo on a warm-up lap. before setting a benchmark time on this 3.4-kilometre circuit.
Here she goes.
See what you've got.
I am actually quite nervous about our car going up against a standard 944 turbo.
Get some power down, baby.
Porsche have spent literally millions making sure their cars are set up for awesome performance, and we've messed with that.
Whoa.
Although on paper it should perform better, if we haven't got our ingredients right, it just might not be the case.
Right, time lap, off we go. Considering this is a standard road going car, it really is doing a good job of this track. Tough car to beat.
That car is going to put a good time down.
Come on, come on, come on!
To the line, to the line, to the line.
Now, 2 minutes, 18 seconds. 2 minutes, 18 to beat.
Right, let's swap you over.
The stock 944 Turbo has lived up to its pedigree. And unless our razzle-dazzle Porsche can beat it by a margin of at least 10 seconds, we've got no chance of finding a buyer. This is make or break time for this build.
This is it! Show me what you can do! Hell and over the line!
That's gotta be quicker! That's gotta be quicker!
That car is ridiculous. I can't stop smiling because it was super fun.
Do you want to hear the figures the standard 944 gave you, our baseline of 2 minutes, 18 seconds. Our Goblin track 944, 2 minutes, 6 seconds. You saved 12 seconds. 12 seconds! It's ridiculous.
On a 3.4-kilometre lap, 12 seconds is a massive improvement.
This has perfectly placed this car for us to sell it for top dollar as a racing track car.
Not only does this car look absolutely beautiful, it performs insanely well.
10% quicker compared to the standard Porsche. We smashed it. That car is ready to be punted for good money.